Let's take a look together, my beloved student. Let's take a look. Can you see it clear? Okay, chit-chat video. The first, let's take a look. We use. We use hope in present tense to express. Today, we use hope to express present tense, right? In present tense. We use hope in present tense to express about wishes. Take a look. Take note together. Wishes. Sorry. Desires. And expectation for the future. What you wish, what you desire, what you expect to happen in the future. You use hope, right? And the next point, there are many ways of using hope in sentences, right? Ways of using hope in sentences. Take a look together. The first point, hope plus two infinitive, which is hope plus two infinitive. Let's take a look together. Example, I hope. After I hope. After hope, you can see two plus study. Two plus verb, we call two infinitive, right? What? Okay, so I hope to study at the campus one day, right? Just hope, you hope, because nowadays we study at home to away from COVID-19, right? But you hope to study, right, at the campus one day. Number two, we use hope plus modal verb can, right? Plus can and plus base verb. Okay, sorry. Let's take a look. We hope, right? We hope, we can. You see, hope and can. We hope we can stay away from COVID-19, right? Because we want to stay away from COVID-19, we study at home through online, right? And number three, hope plus subject plus verb in present simple. Verb in present simple, it means verb that reflect or agree with some subject. Subject means, like I told you, we can have singular noun, plural noun, countable noun, uncountable noun, and also pronoun, right? It is a subject. Example, I hope he does. Because of we use a pronoun he, that's why does finish with an O, we add E-E-S. The root verb is do, right? Okay. I hope he does the right thing. Okay, the right thing. And last but not least, what you are going to know about will and hope. We use will for predictions and hope for wishes, desire, and expectation, right? All my beloved students. Our lesson today, and especially the main focus for today, teacher with will and teacher with hope. How do you feel? You feel comfortable? You feel confident? Or you feel not comfortable? Okay, it means that you get what I mean, you understand what I mean, or you don't understand. If you pay attention, I think this lesson is, it's a piece of cake, right? It's a piece of cake, easy to catch up the meaning. Right, everyone? Okay, so after the main focus that I explained you, please open your textbook together. You can see the page 8 and 9, lesson 4, right, everyone? So please go to page 8 and 9 about future with will and hope. You can read more detail and explore. We have two explore side by side, one. I suggest you to read it by yourself. And We have four exercises for you to practice what you learn, right? To practice what you learn, to check your understanding, how well you understand about what I explanation. That's why I ask you to do exercise one. Write complete sentences using the prompts, right? Using the prompts. In this exercise, we have word, right? Word by word, slash word, slash word, word, slash word, and ask you use your understanding about the lesson to do this exercise. For example, number one, let's take a look example for you. He probably study in Canada. I suppose Cambodia. And example, he will probably study in Canada, right? In Canada, or you can change Canada to Cambodia, right? So we need to insert will, right? We just add will and order the word about in or in order, right? Easy, easy. And number two, number three, number four, I give you to do by yourself, and I take your result then. Okay. And move to exercise two. Exercise two asks you to complete a conversation with all you will or want, right? Instruction. Be careful with instruction. Allow you to do by using all you will or want. So take a look number one together, everyone. We have ABAB, right? One exercise have ABAB. Take a look. What do you think? Are? Because what do? That's why we cannot use are. We use you will. Contraction, you do when you leave school, right? When you leave school. And try to decide by yourself. For example, B. I think. That's why we use I'll, right? Because I think I'll go to university. But I what? I will or I won't go straight away. But because of but is a negative meaning, right? Negative meaning, that's why we can use but. But I won't go straight away. Okay. And what about number four? Number four still A and B, the first conversation. Number four, straight away. Travel first. So we use I'll, right? I'll travel first. I will travel first. After school, travel a few months and go to the university to continue the study. Okay? And exercise three. Okay? Exercise three. Take a look, all my beloved students. Almost finished. Exercise three. Read the sentences. Underline the correct option. Easy for you, right? Just underline, right? Between the side by side of slash. Okay? That you think according to the structure that I provide you for today, right? Take a look again and decide what to choose in the correct way, right? Or in the sentence provide you to do. For example, number one, I hope they rise, not rise. Because of subject pronoun they, we use with verb in present simple without S-E-S or change Y to I-E, right? Okay, and number two, until number eight, I wait to see your result. Okay, and last but not least, exercise four. Exercise four asks you to rewrite the sentences using the verb hope, right? Exercise number 4 allow you to use only verb is. Hope, not will, right everyone? Just allow you to do with hope, right? Just the word hope. For example, number 1, I don't want it to rain. I don't want it to rain. So you rewrite this sentence into hope sentence. I hope it doesn't rain. I hope it doesn't rain. You got what you are going to do, right, about this exercise? Okay, you are clever. Why don't you understand, right? You understand well how to do. But again and again, before you do exercise, please pay attention and read the instruction carefully. Instruction is very useful for you to do exercise. If you understand the instruction, you know how to do exercise, right? Okay, good job all my beloved students. And try to do this exercise by yourself, and the point that you are not clear, you don't understand, you can ask me, right? Ask whoever that you can ask, right? So our lesson today about future with will and hope come to the end. So before we finish our class for today, I give you the homework for you to do, right? So let's wait to see what are they.